What's up, Lakers Nation? I'm Denise Jones, and we're giving you a game day preview for the Lakers and Clippers matchup, and we can't have no other person better for this. Clippers expert, Clippers writer for The Athletic, Jovan Buha, man. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thanks for having me on.
Are you excited to be on?
Yeah, very excited.
You should be, because I'm a big trash talker. To your advantage, LeBron is injured, so he won't be playing in this matchup that we're all looking forward to, but...
It's a big advantage.
That's a big advantage. But that's not to say that the guys aren't going to step up. I feel like, and we talked about this a little off air, just how the small ball is going to be something that's going to be consistent this game. And I do like the way that the young core has stepped up. I do like how Brandon Ingram has stepped up. And I feel like because the refs haven't been working to his advantage, I feel like most NBA teams and most players, some great players could say that. But Brandon Ingram in particular, I feel like is very special because he doesn't necessarily get all the calls that he deserves. And I feel that every game that he has played from the start of the season to now, he's walking around with a bigger chip on his shoulder. He's walking around with just this aggressive, aura to him. I feel like it's something that the guys need. It's something that the young core, I feel like, is always something that they hear a lot of, that they're not aggressive enough. They're not, you know, diving in for them. I feel like Brandon Ingram is definitely stepping up to the plate in a great way. Kyle Kuzma is another one who's well-rounded, who can play multiple positions, and he's just ready to just catch and shoot. He's ready to, you know, just create as much opportunity he can with the ball. And I feel like because he's been playing maybe in the offseason a little longer than most of the other guys with LeBron, he almost has like that veteran IQ sometimes and that veteran vision, because the passes that he takes, rather than taking the shot that we see as fans sometimes as an open opportunity, he creates an even better play with the pass that he makes. So I'm really excited about who we have on the court this matchup. Tell me about the Clippers.
Yeah, so the Clippers had their 16-7 first place start, kind of jumped out the gate, really surprising everybody. They beat the Warriors, they beat the Bucks, they had all these impressive wins. Then December started, right, and things kind of hit the fan where they lost 7-9, kind of came back down to earth. The Cinderella, slipper broke.
Yeah,
I guess would be the best way to put it. And but now that they've kind of bounced back, won 3 of their last 4, the fourth one being a close one in Golden State that they, you know, probably could have won, and lost some, you know, last second layup by Steph. But they've been playing a lot better, and the thing with them has just been their defense this season has been very up and down. They've had times where they've been in the top 10, now they're bottom 7, and it's just kind of been all over the place.
Right.
But I think there's a lot of interesting matchups. Looking at this guy, Shea, him versus Lonzo tonight's going to be interesting. Two different types of players, but they're also very similar. Both 6'6 point guards, kind of funky. Not like great shooters, but they both use their length really well.
Right.
So I think that's going to be an interesting matchup. You got the forward matchups. I know you had Tobias up there earlier. He's had an all-star caliber season, won player of the month for the West. I think him versus, you know, Ingram and Kuzma will be super interesting. But a big one is really going to be this guy, Trez. Trez has kind of been the bellwether for the Clippers this season. When during that stretch where they lost 7-9, he really struggled. And the thing he really struggled against was length and big centers that could kind of just body him in the post and contest him, block his shots, make it difficult. So I think him versus Zubats tonight will be a really big matchup, just because Zubats, you've seen the way he's protected the rim lately, right, blocking a bunch of shots. Golden
Confidence.
State, he was a huge problem against Golden State.
Yeah.
And I think for someone like Trez, you know, a big factor will just be, does he get 20, you know, does he get like 20-8, or does he get like 8-4 and
right,
really struggle? And I think Zubats will be a big factor in that one way or the other. So
yeah.
I think, you know, the Trez matchup off the bench, Clippers usually play their starting center like 12, 15 minutes a night. Then the rest of the time goes to Trez. So they close with him a lot of games. I think that's going to be a big matchup tonight.
Yeah, I'm glad you mentioned Zoo too, just because you're right. He did have quite the performance against the Warriors. And I feel like, you know, you mentioned you guys didn't get the victory that you wanted. I feel like we got the victory for you guys. Christmas Day, best Christmas present I could have ever received this
Clippers
season.
Clippers tired him out.
let's jump on to predictions then. I feel, you know what, because you're the guest, I'm not going to give you my prediction. It's just going to spoil all the fun. You know,
yeah.
So give me your prediction for
so
the outcome.
Just
of
had Gallinari on the slide. I think you mentioned the small ball a little bit. I think there will be some of that tonight. The Clippers have been playing more small ball with Gallinari at the 5. just because their centers have been so unreliable outside of Trez. So that matchup, that lineup's actually been doing really well with small ball. So I do think that's something we could see a lot. And I think the Lakers have the wings and kind of the guys to match up with them right. well in that. So it would not surprise me if, you know, you see that in the fourth, some small ball on both sides. But I think that with LeBron out, I'm going to take the Clippers winning this one in a close one. I think it's going to be close either way, regardless of kind of the outcome.
Right.
But I do think, I think if LeBron had played, I might have predicted a blowout win for the Lakers.
Yeah.
Because I think the one thing with these matchups, and I think from the Clippers side of things, you've seen it when they play the Warriors. The Warriors really get up for playing the Clippers. Right. The Warriors hate the Clippers. They've hated them for years, and they love blowing them out. Mm-hmm. I think it's been the opposite way for the Clippers recently. You know, kind of since the whole Lob City era and the Chris Paul trade and stuff,
right.
they really loved playing the Lakers, blowing them out when the Lakers weren't good.
Right.
You know, they had a couple like 40-point wins. It was like the Clippers really got up for that game. I still think you saw that a little bit last year, that they just love playing the Lakers.
Yeah.
So I think with LeBron out, they're going to really be up for this matchup. But either way, I think it's going to be close, but I'll take the Clippers in a close one.
This game and this matchup in particular, it's such an important game for the city of LA. I mean, that's the whole reason you drove down from far away.
Yeah.
Jovan, you know what I'm saying? And we don't just have special guests like you every day. So it's such an important matchup that Josh Hart, I feel, is going to be the surprise of the game. I feel like Brandon Ingram, Kyle Kuzma, they're going to be as consistent and aggressive as they've always been. And Lonzo's going to be more focused than ever. We know that when Lonzo plays his best games, the Lakers play their best games all together. So I'm predicting a win. I know it's going to be easier for you to predict a win on your side, but unfortunately, it's not going to be an easy game to write about.
You want
to
bet on it?
We should bet on it. Okay. We should bet on it. All right, I didn't think about this, but let's bet on it. Okay, let's make it interesting. I'll make it quick. The Clippers win. I'll throw on some Clipper gear. I'm limited in it.
Okay.
You know, it's fair, but I'll throw some on. The Lakers win. You throw on your Laker gear. I can share some with you. I have a bunch of stuff.
I have a Shaq jersey.
Where could they follow you?
Follow me on Instagram and Twitter at Jovan Buha, JOVANBUHA, and you'll get. I throw some Laker stuff in there here and there, but it is a lot of Clippers content. You'll get some Drake content too.
Yeah. Thank you so much for joining us. Again, Clippers expert, Clippers writer for The Athletic. Make sure to check out his stuff. And remember, for all things Lakers, keep it locked on LakersNation.com.